Lansing, Michigan, in 1997, teenage gymnast Larissa Boyce told a Michigan State University coach that she was uncomfortable with the intravaginal treatments she was getting from Larry Nassar, a MSU sports medicine doctor. Her concerns were not only ignored. Boyce said she was humiliated into thinking that she had unfairly maligned a well-respected doctor. Friday afternoon, Boyce confronted Nassar in an Ingham County courtroom, the last of 89 women this week to give victim impact statements during Nassar's sentencing hearing on charges of first-degree criminal sexual conduct for molesting patients. "I get to see truth and justice prevail. After 20 years of thinking I was the problem," Boyce told Nassar. In many respects, Boyce's story was a microcosm of this week's testimony. The uneasy feelings about Nassar's treatments, the trusting of Nassar and other adults that nothing was awry, the horror of discovering years later the treatments constituted sexual assault, the emotional havoc that discovery unleashed. What Nassar's victims said when they confronted him in court. But Boyce's story is unique in one very important respect. She is the first person known to have complained to MSU officials about Nassar. Yet it took another two decades for Nassar to stop abusing patients. When Boyce first met Nassar, she was a member of a MSU junior gymnastics program run by Kathy Klages, then MSU's head gymnastics coach. She also was a close friend of Nassar, who had just joined the MSU faculty. Nassar had a notable claim to fame. He was team doctor of U.S. gymnasts at the 1996 Olympics, a role he would repeat at the 2002, 2008 and 2012 Olympic Games. So when Boyce experienced an injury, Klages assured her parents that Nassar was the best doctor in town for treating her injury, perhaps the best doctor in the country. William Michelle, Boyce's father, told the court Friday. Boyce said she was uncomfortable with his treatments, which include vaginal penetration, and she and a teammate getting the same treatments went to Klages with their concerns. "This could have stopped in 1997, Boyce said, "but instead of notifying authorities or even my parents, we were interrogated. We were led to believe we were misunderstanding a medical technique." Unlike many Nassar victims who did not talk to others about his treatments, "I told somebody," Boyce said. "I told an adult. I told Michigan State University. Instead of being protected, I was humiliated and told that I was the problem." Boyce said she didn't realize that Nassar and Klages were close friends. "If I had known, I would have never gone to her," Boyce told Nassar. "She chose you over me." In fact, Boyce said, Klages told Nassar about Boyce's concerns, and at Boyce's next appointment with Nassar, pulled up a stool, and said, "So, I talked to Kathy. I had to listen to you explain away your abuse," Boyce told Nassar in the courtroom. "I apologized to you. I apologized for the misunderstanding and said it was all my fault. And to prove to you that I didn't have a dirty mind, I hopped up on that exam table. You were rough and harsh with the treatment that day," Boyce recalled. "I had been defeated. You, Kathy, silenced me." Boyce said she went on to receive more than 100 treatments from Nassar over 4 years, putting aside her doubts and confusion. In September 2016, when Nassar was publicly accused of molesting patients under the guise of medical treatment, Boyce said she was still in denial and initially defended him, unwilling to acknowledge that she was a victim of sexual abuse. The anguish caused by her denial and then her recognition that she was molested, after all, manifested itself in various ways, said Boyce and her husband. Since the Nassar scandal broke, Boyce has struggled with shingles, migraines, panic attacks, suicidal thoughts. In addition to Klages and Nassar, Boyce aimed her wrath at Michigan State University administrators who say they had no idea that Nassar was his molester. "I told Michigan State," Boyce said. "Every time you say that, you are re-shaming, re-victimizing me." Boyce wasn't the only Nassar victim to call out MSU administration on Friday, contributing to a snowballing outcry that resulted in an emergency 4-hour closed-door meeting of the MSU Board of Trustees. Morgan McCall lashes out at Larry Nassar and MSU. At the end of the meeting, the board reaffirmed their support of President Lou Anne Pei Simon. "MSU trustees continue to support Simon tone deaf," Boyce said about MSU. Klages could not be reached for comment. She retired from the university in February 2017, a day after she was suspended by MSU for defending Nassar to her team even after he was fired in September 2016. That included asking her team to sign a sympathy card for him, according to Lindsay Lemke, a MSU gymnast who is among the lawsuit plaintiffs. Klages is one of 4 MSU individuals named as a co-defendant in lawsuits by Nassar victims against MSU. In February, Klages issued a statement saying she was deeply disturbed by the Nasser allegations and extremely distressed by allegations that she tried to impede reports of sexual misconduct. Nasser's sentencing hearing will continue next week in Ingham County Circuit Court.